¿Qué es lo que mi gente? What is up? It is your girl Christina, aka tu vecina favorita que maquilla. And today's video will be another voiceover. And for today, I will be showing a brief history of Dominican music. So I'll be covering a few genres. I will begin with merengue and then go on to cover some of the other genres of music that have come from the Dominican Republic. So if you guys would like to see a brief little history on our music, just keep on watching. Now, when people think of the genre of music that is most native to the Dominican Republic, usually what they think of is merengue. Merengue is 100% Dominican made, and it is a type of music that Dominicans take a lot of pride in. Now, there's actually many types of merengue, but the original, the oldest style of merengue is merengue típico, also known as perico ripiao. Perico ripiao originated in the Cibao region of the Dominican Republic, which is in the northern part of the island, and it is said to have begun all the way starting from the 1840s. Now, originally, this type of music was played with the güira, la tambora, and the guitar, but eventually would be replaced with the accordion, thanks to Germans who traveled to the island in the 1880s as part of the tobacco trade. And that is now what is typically seen when you see a group playing merengue típico. You see the accordion, la güira, and la tambora. So this type of music originated among the poor country people. And prior to the 1930s, it was actually not very accepted by most people to hear or play this type of music. People considered it to be immoral, or they tried to ban it due to the quote-unquote provocative dance that was done to it. But these efforts to keep the music suppressed were to no avail, as Trujillo would eventually declare it the national music of the Dominican Republic. Now this here is Francisco Antonio Lora Cabrera, also known as Migo Lora, and many consider him to be the father of merengue típico. Now, I'm going to go out on a limb here and say that I might be related to this man because my last name is also Lora, and I don't know a whole lot of Loras outside of my family, so you never know. You never know. Anyway, I'm joking. But yes, he was considered the father of merengue, and some of his contemporaries include Toño Abreu and Hipólito Martínez.
Juanita Morel, oye tu merengue, Juanita Morel, oye tu merengue, entre las mujeres tú eres mi derriengue, entre las mujeres tú eres mi derriengue, lolola.
Now, beginning in the 70s and 80s, merengue would continue to evolve, and it would become what we now know as merengue clásico, as well as merengue de orquesta. And many consider this time period, especially the 80s, to be los años dorados del merengue, or the golden years of merengue. This is when you began to see a lot of big bands. A lot of different instruments began to be incorporated into merengue, especially the trumpet, different types of percussion, and other wind instruments, and two musicians which really helped to put merengue on the map in an international level were Johnny Ventura and Wilfrido Vargas.
Traigo la salsa para tu lechón y vengo contento, negrita y bien sabroso.
Que llegó Nochebuena y hay que celebrar. Olvide sus penas, mi hermano, y venga a bailar.
Yo traigo la salsa para tu lechón. Y vengo contento, negrita y bien sabroso.
Now, the 80s brought with it a whole bunch of different artists that would rise to fame, including Bonnie Cepeda, Las Chicas del Gang, which were one of the first female musicians to really get a name in merengue, and others such as Fernanito Villalona and El Zafiro.
Esta noche tengo ganas de cantar y de llevarle a mi novia serenata. Con mis amigos me le voy a presentar para ponerle una parranda.
From the 8 ladies and into the 1990s, artists such as Los Hermanos Rosario, Sergio Vargas, and of course, Dominican Republic's incredibly loved Juan Luis Guerra would continue to put Dominican on the map and elevate merengue to an international level where people from all countries would come to greatly love our music. Now, another type of merengue that began to get very popular in the late 80s and early 90s is merengue de guitarra. And this type of merengue is actually personally one of my favorite types, and it is very closely related to bachata. And you will find that a lot of bachateros play this type of merengue as well. And it is similar to bachata in that the primary instrument used in this type of merengue is the guitar. You don't really hear the saxophone or the accordion like that. It's mainly just guitar.
Bueno, ya que hay mucha gente que sabe en el bochinche. Yo tampoco juego, bro.
Now, in the latter half of the 20th century, many Dominicans would find themselves migrating to the United States, primarily to New York, and thus was created the new generation of Dominican Americans, such as myself. Now, in the late 80s and early 90s, these young Dominicans, mainly living in New York, would create their own genre of music, which would eventually become merengue house or merengue hip hop. Now, this particular type of merengue was a mix of merengue, but with American hip hop and rap. So the musicians in this type of music would mainly be rapping. And if you're familiar with early 90s type of hip hop, you can definitely tell the resemblance between the two. It's basically a fusion of both Dominican and American culture.
Merengue hip hop is my motto. Jump up and down, bring papa arriba y pa abajo. Magic one es el hombre de la hora. Proyecto uno gives you more of that stuff. That's tough, no bluff.
rough enough. Yo quiero bailar, yo quiero cantar. I wanna dance and sing like a star. Sana, sana, culito de rana. Today's a Puerto Rican y mañana es una...
Now, fast forward 10 or so years, and now we have merengue de calle, or as some call it, mambo. Now, this is a very fast-paced type of merengue, and it doesn't always use live instruments. A lot of it is electronically done. I'm not sure what's the correct terminology for that, but I think we can agree that the face of this genre is Omega. He was the one that really started getting people into this type of music. And so for this next clip, I will be playing one of his songs.
Trepo en la mata a pasito de gigante, pero hay muchos mamberos que quieren tumbarme el plante, porque en tarima yo brillo como diamante, pues yo vine de atrás, pero ahora estoy adelante, el que no tenga la bujía que se quite, porque este loco si...
Now that we have covered merengue, we can finally move on to bachata. Now, personally, of all the Dominican genres of music, this is my favorite. This is the one that appeals to me the most. Now, similar to Bericuri Piao, at the beginning, it was not socially accepted, and then it was even probably looked down on more than Bericuri Piao was. Now, this type of music was actually banned for most of the Trujillo era, as a lot of people saw this as a music of poor people. A lot of people considered it to be vulgar. It was associated with loose women. It was stuff that you would hear in like the bar and los cabaretes. And actually, to this day, my mom still has a kind of negative perception of it. Me, I'm the opposite. To me, I consider bachata just to be something that just speaks to your soul. It's just powerful. It can just evoke so many types of emotion, especially, you know, it's a bachata de amargue, you know, which many consider the Dominican version of the blues. So the very early bachata, it sounds more like bolero. And this is what people say bachata actually it came from that bolero type of style. So I will play a few clips of the original OGs of bachata, including Luis Segura and Marino Perez.
No sé qué será de mí hoy que yo no tengo a nadie. No sé qué será de mí que yo no tengo a nadie. Un amor que yo tenía también se alejó de mí.
Se está acabando con lo que me queda, poquito a poquito. Dime qué te ha hecho, negra consentida, mi corazoncito.
So now, of course, we have to move on to lo más duro de la bachata, okay? The kings, the ones that really elevated bachata to an international level. And now the whole world loves bachata. So now on to these next few gentlemen.
Ay, estoy sufriendo, no sé lo que voy a hacer. Ay, estoy sufriendo, no sé lo que voy a hacer. Se me ha ido mi mujer y yo no la pude ver. Se me ha ido mi mujer y yo no la pude ver.
¿A dónde estará mi dulce mujer? ¿A dónde estará mi dulce mujer? a cualquiera trastorna. Por eso yo ando loco de amor. Hasta de madrugada camino por tu barrio. Ya piensa el vecindario que yo soy un ladrón. Tú que sabes lo que hago, dile que no soy malo.
Ya Rosa encontró la cura, ya está el tremendo dolor. Ya Rosa encontró la cura, negralita, ya está el tremendo dolor. Que le negue su alma cuando desprecie su amor. Que le negue su alma, negralita, cuando desprecie su amor.
Now, we can't talk about bachata without mentioning Aventura, the young kids from New York that showed their love for bachata and really introduced a much younger American generation to bachata. The achievements they have done, I mean, all the records they have created, bachata wouldn't be where it is today without Aventura's contribution as well.
Son las 5 de la mañana y yo no he dormido nada. Pensando en tu belleza, en loco voy a parar. El insomnio es mi castigo, tu amor será mi alivio. Y hasta que no seas mía, no viviré en paz. He conocido un novio, pequeño y no buen mozo. Y sé que él no te quiere por su forma de hablar. Además tú no lo amas, porque él no da la talla, no sabe.
Prince Royce is another young kid who has also made a name for himself in bachata and has also been able to appeal to both younger and older generations as well.
Royce. When the night has come,
now, one particular type of Dominican music that sometimes gets left out of the conversation son los palos dominicanos. Now, this type of music is definitely not a mainstream type of music. It's not something you're going to hear at your everyday party or at a club or something. But this particular type of music is directly African derived. It is said to come, its roots are from the Congo region of Africa, and as far as its role in Dominican society, it's played at religious ceremonies or festivals honoring certain saints. So this type of music is played on three long drums called palos, and they're called palo, meaning tree, because the drums are made out of basically hollowed out logs. So in this type of music, it's really just comprised of the drums and la guira, and the other main instrument is basically the voice. And so I will play a few clips of some palo music. Now, last but not least, we will be moving on to el género urbano, which is dominated right now by el dembow dominicano. Now, this is very popular among the youth today, and it's not to be confused with reggaeton, although they do sound very similar. Now, dembow itself is a rhythm native to Jamaica, but it is also the basis for reggaeton and dancehall. Now, dembow is a bit faster, and it incorporates some rap and hip-hop elements as well. Now, the top dog in the game right now is El Alfa. There's also Bulin 47, which is pretty pegado right now. There's Chimbala. There's Lirico en la Casa, Moza la Para, just to name a few.
A mí no me compare que yo tengo pa' comprar la competencia. Yo firmo el movimiento entero con su descendencia. Todos los días voy pa' arriba y tú te desesperas. Y cada vez que subo un piso quito la escalera. Todos los demagogos me lo quite de la vera. Y como quiera se quieren quedar pegados en la tetera. La calle tiene fuego, la calle tiene falla. Como quiera que la tire, el alfa no la falla. Todo el mundo me quiere, yo tengo los chavos. Y las mujeres me lo lamen como la paleta el chavo. Hasta los demagogos me dan palo. Tú quieres que te mate a tiro, que te mate a palo. Llegando.
Me mantiene a mi hijo, me mantiene a mi mamá, me mantiene a mi papá, me mantiene a mi tío, me mantiene a mi abuela, me mantiene a mi sobrino, me echa gasolina, me paga la tarjeta, me paga la ropa, me paga la bebida. Entonces, no, envidioso, no, o deja de hablar de mí.
Prendí y no se apagó, andamos en la calle dando pares con el pasón. Cuidado si se te para el corazón, que yo soy la pastilla pa' tu mujer de la depresión. Yo le di, después llamó, dijo que le gustó y lo repitió. No sabía que era del vecino cuando me lo dio. Tenía una amiga y pa' completarle ya me gastó.
Ahora no deje buscarme después que esa noche yo la maté. No se conformó con lo que yo le hice y tuvimos que darle los tres.
¿Cómo así?
And that, guys, concludes this video. I hope y'all enjoyed this little quick rundown of our musical history. Let me tell you, it took some work to put this video together, but I had fun doing it. Again, I hope you guys enjoyed it. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. Check out my Dominicana de Pura Cepa series, and I will check you guys in the next video. Bye!